Set your butane torches to high and your expectations to low. Coming to you live from just the tip cigars in the hills of the Steel City, get ready to get your fix. This is the Cigar Junkies Podcast.
Welcome to the Cigar Junkies Podcast,
the cigar show for the community by the community.
A forum that talks stogies, booze, food, and anything else in cigar lifestyle.
If you're looking for ratings, negativity, reviews, or an authority on all things cigars, you came to the wrong place.
Whether you like what you hear or not, please join the conversation and let us know by finding us at the Cigar Junkies Facebook group
or emailing us at thecigarjunkies@gmail.com.
What's up, junkies? I'm Corey.
I'm Sam.
I think I'm Jason.
Last time I checked, you were. And if you were listening or watching this, you're the Cigar Junkies, just like we are. And that means we need your help. Remember, if you're listening to this, you can help us with your incredible support by liking, sharing, and subscribing on every platform. Now, you can even go to thecigarjunkies.com or thecigarjunkiespodcast.com or one other thing. But thecigarjunkies.com just rolls,
That's easy.
Man. That's the easy one.
Don't forget the though.
The though. Don't forget the.
The Cigar Junkies.
It's where?
Correct.
The important
dot,
one.
Dot com. I thought we weren't doing .com.
Yeah, we're not going to be in the future. So let's get that out of the way right now. We are a little bit concerned about the different algorithms and so forth, and YouTube's constantly adjusting criteria for ways that they can get rid of cigar content. One of those is supposedly directing to a website for purchasing or whatever, but .com may be something that we lose. So if we go the website and we go the Cigar Junkies website, or if I say just a tip website, you know, there's a .com in there
.com.
You know what I mean?
I do.
So, yeah. Welcome to the Cigar Junkies Podcast, your favorite alternative lifestyle show.
Yeah. We're hanging out in Flavor Country today.
Okay.
All right.
This is going to be interesting. Corey's not drinking. Everybody else is.
I know. I just figured it wasn't fair for you to not even be around it. Like, it might help motivate you, keep you going, just knowing that we're doing it for you.
I could care less about you guys. I just wish I could a little bit because of circumstances that I'm sure we'll touch on at some point.
Yeah.
Throughout the show. So I chose a poor color to wear with the new lighting.
Yeah, it's a lot.
I did not get a logo tattooed on my hairless chest, although trust me, my chest is hairless.
Oh no, most of us are aware.
A lot of you, yeah.
What's up, Colby? Hi, Heather.
Do we forget this stream deck? What's going on over here?
Things are just happening.
Something's loose.
Oh, something is awry, Eric? In the Matrix. He said he knows you. So how was your week?
Nope. How was your week?
Why mine?
Because mine was not good.
What'd you do?
Nope.
No, now you got us all curious. Now you have to tell us first.
Work sucked.
Is that why you didn't get here till like 7 o'clock for our 4 o'clock meeting?
Work sucked.
Oh man, that's I've got a good story for you.
How was your week, Jason?
We'll let him lead in.
I like the way it looks like there's a picnic table behind you.
There is.
He's
a picnic
got like
table
this like
me.
White trash Yogi Bear thing going on.
Yeah. Hell yeah. It's a picnic basket, boo boo.
It's a picnic basket.
So was it Tuesday or Wednesday? So Corey comes in. I was working the overnight shift, and Corey comes in to relieve me. And
not what you think, Eric.
We get the mill shut down for shift change. And Corey and I are standing there talking, probably about 7 or 8 minutes.
Oh,
and yeah. I got the picture here too. So about 7 or 8 minutes, Corey and I are standing there talking. It gets to 7:02 or something like that. You're fine, by the way, Sam. It gets to 7:02, and
that means the new turn starts, so they start running.
So now it's Corey's shift, and we hear the mill spool up, and it goes.
Jason looks at me like, all right, see you, buddy.
Bye.
I went, whoa, what was that? And we turned out, and there's smoke pouring out of the mill. And one of the guys that works on shift, they open up the door so you can see inside the mill, and it's just destroyed. I pat Corey on the shoulder, and I was like, take me to the locker room.
and he goes, never mind, I'll walk.
Yes, Dad, never mind, I'll walk.
I'll walk.
There was shrapnel. That is not super common from what I've seen. There was shrapnel. There is just... It looked like somebody put a piece of aluminum foil
it looked
in
like
a blender,
that.
But by a lot more.
Oh, shit. Shnikes.
Oh, man, you almost got him.
Oh. Oh,
and that's only what you could see.
Oh, what happened?
Yeah.
That's called a mill wreck.
Yep. It's like if you left a cheeseburger in foil on your table and left your dog alone with it and you came back into the room, right?
But like, wow.
Yeah.
That's.
Yep.
So that's coming through.
It was pretty vicious.
That mill spins.
Yeah.
And that steel comes through that mill at like 55 miles an hour.
Yeah.
It's fast.
So we're not going to show the picture anyway because it's work and you don't want to get in trouble. Uh-uh. So there's no visual. But if you're trying to understand what we're talking about, Jason and I work in the part of the steel mill.
Wait,
where a full coil comes through. What?
Go ahead. I accidentally scrolled, and that was the next picture.
Oh, what is it? Let me see. Is it a goose?
It's a goose. Why? Why is that the I didn't mean to scroll, but it was just like, ding. Oh. I'm like, what is this?
I think that needs to be the thumbnail picture for Eric's new podcast, Groundhogs and Beavers. But there's just a picture of a goose for some reason. Ew. And a smoking jacket.
The goose that laid the golden shampoo bottle.
So the goose does have a purpose.
Oh, does he now?
So my son and I were like, it was during Christmas time. My son and I were listening to like old weird Christmas songs. Right. So we were listening to like old Irish Christmas songs, old English Christmas songs and stuff like that. And we come across this song by a band called the Oxford Waits. And it's an old like folky like polka song called The Wonderful Christmas Goose.
Folka?
And my daughter hates the song. She's like, that is the stupidest song I've ever heard. I hate this song. And my son and I have just been tormenting her with The Wonderful Christmas Goose.
Him. Maybe you should back out and come back in.
Yeah.
He only sees the logo on his life, but I see
there
you
it is. I was like,
He's good. It's not you.
Jason, I can see.
Jason, yeah. I see you.
Thank you.
Chicken it.
Thang.
The donkey?
Yes.
Hee-haw. I was traveling down the road and I saw a donkey.
Hee-haw. As long as we're bird walking.
Yeah,
somebody I was staying with yesterday. Oh, Rex the millwright. Uh-huh. So we're sitting there trying to start up the mill, and we're like literally standing there with crossed fingers. I wanted to look over at him and quote Clerks too. Maybe we should cross chickens too. But I didn't say that because I didn't know if you'd understand. I'm like, you ever see Clerks too? He's like, no, but Clerks 1's great. I'm like, okay, here's the scene.
I'm gonna
Dante in this little
set scene.
I'm going to put my head in the fryer.
Yeah.
Balls 2.
That's right. He isn't there yet. That's that's got to be our first not. Junkies watch along.
Okay, yeah, Clerks 2.
Let me put this week into perspective for you. The day that he's describing is the best day I had this week at work.
Oh, I'll bet.
Because it was all investigation day.
No, there's no investigation. You clean it up and you keep going. But then, at
sorry,
some point,
said.
This is on. I'm so my brain has so little RAM today. I can't even go backwards to try to latch on to what it was that I said that he said that to.
You just clean up and keep going.
Yeah. No memory. Anywho's
yours is still working. Mine has given up.
Ah, okay. Wow. You don't want to.
I did see the Ronin for a second, though.
It was cool, though, right?
Like it popped up
at the beginning again.
No, it still says live.
Anywho.
Yeah.
Actually, we got back up and running very, very well and easily right after that. But then a couple of days ago, a piece of that shrapnel must have fallen through and started causing the worst couple of days. What happened was the lower backup, a piece of scrap must have come down between the work roll and the lower backup. They thought that the work roll was jacked, so they would go to change the work roll. It's fine, no problem. And then they put in a new set of rolls, same things there. Like, how are they both have the same thing? Pull it out, look, it's on the backup. The day before, everybody was worried, Friday, we only have one mechanic out. We won't be able to do this, so make sure backups are changed just in case of an emergency. And I'm like, I've been here 2 years. We've never needed an emergency backup change, and you never build them. But okay, cool. Do what you got to do. Well, guess what? We needed to change backups for an emergency.
Found out, eh?
Guess what? There were two sets of backups set up in the back of the mill. Neither set was finished.
Of course not.
Oh, man. That was the start of... The 2 days ago, that was the meeting day where I come in 2 hours late.
You're like, I get a text that just says, yeah, I'm going to be late. And then I get another text right after from Jason, like, Corey's not going to be there on time. And I was like, oh, something good happened. Something great.
There's
some guy caught the pickle line on fire.
Then, damn.
That could never happen. Eric's you have firework watch. You have fire watch for just that reason. That's right. You'll be okay.
They call it the Ryan Seneca watch.
Yeah.
Did you read the comments there? I like it. Corey literally looks like a thumb.
Yeah, there you go.
Eric could use him as a tenth toe.
Transformers, robots in disguise.
Eric takes off his shoe and there's Corey.
Hi, guys. Hey guys. Wait. But in the intro video, there's a hyphen between Transformers.
We're gonna get canceled. Stop.
Oh, dude, we're already canceled. That's why it's okay. It's so much more fun.
See, that's the thing. That's why we have a gay guy in the audience.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
That's like our buffer. We're like, see, no, we're inclusive.
Yeah. And we have Eric, too. So yeah. Seneca. Maybe that's wrong. Maybe it'll be a good show.
Fire cured, the official cigar of the pickle line.
Not yet.
That was a Seneca comment. That was
real quick before we talk, because we're gonna go past this. I need to get past this.
Okay.
However, yesterday we set a record for a consecutive number of different reasons that the mill was broke down and didn't run all day. I'm gonna put it in perspective for you. There's a group chat that our coordinator started, yes, mm-hmm. with all the other bosses, because it's Saturday and everybody's at home, so it's a text group chat instead of an email. At one point, at 12:15, he says, hey, how's it going? And I'm sitting there going, like, I can't believe he hasn't checked in yet. We're just about to get running and stuff. And so I responded, I'm like, I don't want to jinx it. And so that's all I said. So we get a few quills through the mill, and then so I update the group. I'm like, okay, guys, we got 3 quills through the mill. We got a good rollout. Everything looks good to go. And he chimes in. He's like, awesome, that's good to know, blah, 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 blah. The timestamp didn't even change. My next text message was still in the same minute. The jib crane blew up. and the coordinator responds back, and he goes, blew up seems like an extreme description. When you get more time, can you tell us what happened? And he sends a picture, a gif of Wile E. Coyote lighting a rocket and it just blowing up in his eyes. And I'm like, I didn't say it, but I'm like, it pretty much sums it up. So I'm like, it sparked, then it started smoking, and it doesn't work.
It blew up. Yeah, it's blowed up.
Let's find out what the cigar of the week is. Right. Much like our jib crane, it's fire cured.
This from you guys, right?
Yes.
It's time for the Cigar of the Week, brought to you by Leaning House Fine Cigars. The Leaning...
It's time for the Cigar of the Week, brought to you by Just the Tip Cigars. Are you looking for the best selection of boutique cigars? Do you want the tried and true legacy brands that are synonymous with the cigar lifestyle? Do you want luxurious cutters, lighters, and other accessories? Do you want to relax in the most comfortable cigar lounge in the burg? Then you want Just the Tip Cigars. Conveniently located in the Bavarian Village Shopping Center in South Park, Pennsylvania, Just the Tip Cigars has been tailor-built to your smoking needs. Whether you visit in person or on the web at justthetipcigars.com, when it comes to cigars, Just the Tip is the whole package. Yeah, anyways, I want to know if, first of all, that was, if you're not watching the live, just looking at me trying to mime to Jason for the last 15 seconds during that commercial. I was saying, turn the monitor up so I could hear it a little better so I'd know when it was
over. Buddy, that's why you're muted. So you could have been like, hey, Jason, can you turn the monitor up a little bit? Because I can't hear it.
Yeah, but you
it.
Still have your earphones on. I was actually talking and pointing. So anywho's, I want to know if we could just start our new intro.
Can we? Are you okay?
Yeah, fine.
Are you sure you're okay?
Can we have a new intro that starts with Jason's laugh like Roseanne used to?
No, I want to pull the I'm Jason. I want to just pull the O from the beginning of when he said that, like two episodes, and just be like, oh, Cigar Junkies. Just get it going.
I wonder if we could get a DJ to just mix in. It's not a pee-pee. It's not a
pee-pee. No, it's not a pee-pee. It's not over the backing noise.
That's right. The Just a Tip Cigar of the Week is the Drew Estate Subculture Kentucky Fire Cured. This is the 5x56 Fat Molly Robusto. It is a San Andreas wrapper, Nicaraguan binder, and fillers from Kentucky and Virginia. This is an extension to the Muat, which stands for My Uzi Weighs a Ton brand, which I think went away. I think that's one of the ones that's gone. They're produced at the Hoya de Nicaragua factory, or at least they used to be. Fire cured tobacco is a little bit different. If you're not familiar with that, typically what they do during the curing process for tobacco is you put the tobacco in palones, you hang it from rafters in a barn, and let it air dry. This is a sped up process that adds I don't want to call it an infusion, but it imparts a flavor of that smoke, much like whenever you peat a whiskey on the tobacco. So essentially what happens is inside the barn, they light a big old fire and they fire.
Then they catch the barn on fire like Fuente did with all the Opus stuff.
That could happen. I think that was just a ploy to try to make their crap even more rarer.
No, aged. They would never do that. Not Fuente. What's up, Chris Scales?
Eric, you'll be happy to know that for this process, they use hardwoods.
Very important portion of that.
Yes, yes.
Always got to be. So what are your thoughts on this cigar that you were...
All the ladies today, man.
I know. All the single ladies. None of them are single ladies. Oh, no, wait.
So currently, it's... I don't know, man. Like, I like fire-cured tobacco. This is not a great example of it. This would be like if you were like, hey, man, I really love a good cheeseburger, and someone was like, you know, here's what's the cheap McDonald's. Sorry.
Speaking of single ladies, hi, Dougie Doug.
Hey. Yeah, this is like somebody like, oh, you love burgers? You got to try this. And then giving you like a quarter pounder or whatever the cheap McDonald's.
Yeah, whichever. There's McDouble.
McGangbang? That's
the cheapest of the cheapest.
A McDouble. McDoubles are all right, actually.
So
it seems to be some sort of communique.
It's communique. You were not looking forward to this cigar.
Not as much. Not as such.
Talking about it, it was I've never had it. Jay, I don't think you've ever had it.
Negative.
So I was like, well, we're gonna give it a shot. We've heard things about it. Initial thoughts are meh.
I wouldn't say it's offensive.
No. Right?
Like if you were, let's say you took a drive out somewhere, okay? And you're driving, there's like a lookout, and you're like, oh, I'm going to pull over and check out the view. Like, you know, and what would make this great, a cigar? And you start digging around in your car and you don't have anything but this. If you had it to cut and light up for me, it'd be like, yeah, it's a cigar.
Yeah.
I really like fire-cured tobacco, and this is not a good representation of what I like about it.
I feel like it doesn't have the oily, like, I don't know, the elegant, creamy smoke that is off of some of the other fire-cured representations.
Well, my...
shampoo ball? Oh, it's a coffee cup.
My...
I fell out of Jason.
The first fire-cured cigar that I had was the...
Extra Viejo.
No, is it the Alma?
Forte?
No, the Icarus?
The Amarillo.
The Amarillo. DBL. Yeah, that's why I asked the Extra Viejo first.
Yeah, the Amarillo, and that's...
DBL Amarillo, that's fancy my, Bellicoso.
Yeah, that's my baseline for a fire-cured cigar.
And that's not even super fire-cured, but there's a lot of baking spice type of flavors in that. Mm-hmm. It has a lot of taste happening.
Yeah.
And it stands out apart from a normal cigar a lot.
Yeah, very much so. It's definitely unique in its ways. So what are you thinking of this then? You initial beliefs.
Based off our scale, I would smoke it for free.
Well, so pretty much same as what you just said. Like,
yeah.
Yeah. I'd smoke it for free. I don't see myself grabbing another one.
If somebody was like, say, made it the cigar of the week and said you have to smoke it for the podcast, you would.
Yeah.
I'd even smoke it if somebody was like, hey, I got a box of these. You want one? Be like, yeah. I'll take one.
Yeah, sure.
It doesn't turn me green and make me want to be like, no, screw that. I'm never going to smoke another cigar.
No, that's what Swamp Thing's for.
It's not offensive.
Nah, not at all.
And there's plenty of people smoking these, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's someone's favorite cigar.
Yeah.
I sell quite a few.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Not after this show.
Why not?
Is that note going to stay on the screen the whole
time? Yeah, you can't just like, the point of it is if you leave it there all the time, we won't.
What if my joke isn't funny? Because most of them aren't. Are those okay?
No, those are fine. Okay. But you know what? I should put a caveat in there.
All right. Sounds painful.
Okay.
Yep, that's the caveat.
No Rich Bozeman jokes.
Correct.
That's like 90% of our
Keep material. It classy, San Diego.
That's exactly what San Diego needs to do. No.
Anchorman. Anchorman, yeah.
He has a different statement for San Diego elsewhere in the movie.
Yeah.
That's very appropriate for San Diego, actually.
So what are you guys drinking?
Wapsie Bourbon by Wiggle.
Sounds like drinking, you can't even talk right.
We're drinking coffee because it's 10 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. Highly caffeinated.
I was going to say, it's 10 o'clock, guys. I think you might have a problem. You know what I mean? Maybe it's
says the guy at 9:30 in the morning who pours himself a triple shot in a rocks glass.
Walks in and goes, I can't.
Easy, Ric Flair. Easy. Sorry, audio listeners.
You've got to walk that out.
Now walk it out.
Okay, brings back a memory. So when I come in for the meeting the other day, when I came in the other day with my friends, you were in the humidor, you were occupado. Mm-hmm. He was off jibber jabbering with somebody. Mm-hmm. Paul's sitting over there, look in this direction. I come in, look around. I'm like, yeah, I don't know. I set my crap down. I storm in the humidor, grab my cigars, bring them over here. Don't pay for them. Cut open a box, pull one out, cut it, light it, grab a glass, fill it. Literally, not one of those glasses, a bigger glass, halfway with tequila. Slam it, and then smoke my cigar and start pouring another one. And as I'm doing this, I'm just focused on what I'm doing. I look over, and little old Paul's just sitting on the couch watching me. He goes, bad day? Yeah, you can say that.
Bad day? Mm-hmm. But at least it was not 9 o'clock in the morning when this occurred. This was in the evening times.
That's correct. Although if you worked all night.
Right. Oh, I had a lot of 7 a.m. beers.
Dude, I had one the other day.
The
other day. Had one the other day. Come home. My wife's laying on the couch. And I'm standing with a beer in my hand, 7 o'clock in the morning. She's like, is that a beer? I was like, yeah. Yeah, it is. I
7 p.m.
worked 12 hours yesterday through the night. I'm going to have a beer before I go to bed.
Yep. It was not uncommon when I was oil field, especially, but even at Eastman, I'd come home from midnight shift and there'd be a glass bottle of bourbon and a sandwich sitting on the island. As soon as I'd walk in the kitchen, I'd just walk in and be like, she's not there. I'd go out on the deck and just chill. But yeah, you know, nice bedtime pour. Get you
night especially. Camp.
Yeah.
Little night camp.
Cleans it up. It's nice. Like,
you know what? Did you travel a lot when you were in the oil field?
Yeah.
Shower beers back at the hotel, dude. Bro. Those were my favorite.
Bro.
Road beers?
No, shower beers.
No, I liked road beers.
My favorite was absolutely the
Wasn't Phoenix. Trying to get a DUI.
Yeah.
Yeah, but there was some Canadian in the front of the truck driving whenever I was drinking.
Oh, 100%, yeah. Dude. I'd have a truck full of dudes.
Yeah.
Right?
Jesus.
We really are in flavor country now. Hey, Eric.
Can you write him a note and hold it up? No blasphemies.
So, So I would, the whole crew would be in the truck, right? We'd get in the truck on the site. As soon as we'd hit past that guard check on the road, you'd hear. Yep. I look around. I'm like, you savages, man.
Sounded like somebody turned on dubstep.
Yeah.
What was the swallowing noise from?
Jason.
If he walks like a goose, my microphone will not stay erect.
Yeah, what happened there? You're drifting.
You got to watch yourself. You're like hunched over a lot, like trying to get at that microphone.
Yeah, the mic was sinking on him.
Sit up straight. You're a big boy.
I am sitting up straight. I'm just really short.
Yes. And?
So I'm going to actually like give you guys a little bit of a window into my psyche.
Please don't.
You don't know
Please
this.
Please don't. I'm begging you.
I don't even like tequila. I just hate doing this show. That's why I normally drink it.
Is that it? Sounds about right.
No, I'm kidding. I like doing the show.
The still people, hates tequila.
Not always the people, you know what I mean?
Wow, you just go into a dark place there with that, huh? Hold on.
I can't go into a dark place. There's a spotlight on me. It looks like I was trying to get out of prison and they nailed me against the wall. And I'm like,
I got you.
Well, you should wait. You actually timed it perfect where like as my arm went like this, it switched and your arm was going like this.
Hold it back up as you just did. Higher. Little further out. Yeah. Get like a nice little, and then he changes the camera.
Yeah, I did it on purpose.
What is happening here?
He's trying to block the light.
I'm putting a filter on the light. Nice little golden hue.
Oh, what's that about a golden shower?
Oh, that's so nice.
Yeah, but it looks so bad.
I do, man. I feel like, and I'm just up against the prison wall.
Yeah, it's a real bright light there. It is distracting because like right here is super illuminated that I'm not used to, but it's still better than having the lights in my face hole.
It casts a complimenting shadow across your face.
Yeah, I'll take it. So anyways, we got to talk about something other than nothing. So, really? I guess Seinfeld did like how many seasons of nothing, huh?
We're like 30 minutes into not shutting up.
Really?
At all.
Man, we have problems.
And I haven't even consumed.
What do you mean?
Are you saying hell yes to the consuming or to the having problems? Bro, if you turned your with that hat on, if you turned your eyes crooked, you'd look like from an Buscemi? Adam Sandler movie. Yeah, Buscemi.
Crazy eyes.
Yeah, crazy eyes.
Sure was nice of Deeds to buy us all Ferraris.
As soon as I said the eyes, and you were just like, yes, yes.
Yeah, we knew who you were.
Look up crazy eyes, Mr. Deeds. What's going on, Jimmy Green? Thank you for your hello from Kentucky.
Kentucky.
Kentucky. So they were smoking a Kentucky Fire Care. Timings. Mm-hmm. I haven't even looked at the notes yet.
Okay.
Okay.
You wanted me to start talking about something that wasn't nothing. Is that what you were trying to?
I mean, that's usually how it goes. You usually just like start going really and then we all kind of just play.
You want to talk about the cigar news brought to you by nobody music.
If you talk about the cigar news, you can bump us again before you do it.
I could bump. I don't know, man. I'm only human.
Do it.
It is snowing like crazy.
I have limitations.
It was 70 on Monday, dude.
The Pennsylvania weatherman is trying really hard to get me to put some change in the cup.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we haven't.
Jay and Silent Bob. I think I just
not one yet.
Do you keep playing with the quarters just to remind yourself?
Yes, yes. Anytime I feel the need to swear, I'm going to sit here and
go, "All right, guys, I'm an ante up."
Can I just put a 10 spot in there and be good for the day? Well, so what do you got? Brought to you by
the Cigar Junkies Podcast. So
loving. Is what I got.
Da, 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 da.
Remember that.
He's loving it. Write that down.
Very different places we are.
Oh, yeah. I went like
there's a button for that.
Write that down.
Let's shall we?
Let's shall.
Cigar news. Lots of this is going to be coming to you from the PCA trade show. Espinosa Premium Cigars has announced the 601 La Bamba Warhead X. The X is the 10th installment of Espinosa's successful limited edition Warhead series. It is packaged in a large wall-mountable gold-painted bomb containing 10 cigars. The Warhead is a 6x55 Toro oval made with filler, binder, and broadleaf wrapper grown in Nicaragua. Do you know what an oval means? I'm assuming that's a soft box press, perhaps?
Maybe.
Yeah, 6x55 oval.
I don't know.
This year's run will be 5,000 boxes. The cigars will retail for 16 paper Washingtons. That's how we say it in the Pittsburghs. With 10-count boxes at 106. I mean, there's no discount for a box, it seems. Warhead X has been blended by Espinosa Premium Cigars and made at the San Antonio factory in Ocotal, Nicaragua.
Ocotal?
Yeah. I wanted to say Aquatine.
Octomom, what?
Octomom. At the 2024 PCA Trade Show, Oveja Negra Brands introduces the Blackwork Studio Paper Crane. Paper Crane is a small batch release. You can see it coming when the tobacconist is standing on one leg with his arms in the air, and you could try, but
Ralph
no block.
Macchio.
No block. No can block.
No can block. Oh,
Jason, Alexa. You look like you wanted it, and you just left
now,
it
was
go.
That you guys who were?
We were talking about the enemies thing. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. They were like, this guy, you know,
he's
Cobra
the actual.
Kai. Yeah, he's the bad guy. Yeah.
Daniel, that we had like a whole 30-minute segment on that. Actually, you were here.
Most of it got cut.
No, that was wrong show.
No, okay. I remember the shows. Plans are for the Paper Crane to ship to retailers by the end of the month, highlighted by a Connecticut Florado wrapper. The remainder of the blend consists of an Ecuadorian Habano binder, fillers from Nicaragua. Line is offered in a Corona Gorda box press and Toro box press, each size packaged in 20-count boxes, and pricing set from 11 to 12. Patina has announced it will begin shipping the Patina Oro to Nicaragua this week. It is the fifth regular production line from Patina Cigars. The company has said it will have limited samples at the upcoming show, which opens March 23rd, 24 in Vegas. So maybe my timing's a little off, but this is all like PCA announcements. So it's like, if they're announcing it at the trade show, why is it already announced? You know, that make anybody else scratch their head.
Does it say that they're announcing it there? That's
General
silly.
Cigar Company. Well, it depends on how I copied it in and changed it
that's
as well.
Strange.
General Cigar Company has just released its Punch Knuckle Buster shade, the third blend in Punch's value priced Knuckle Buster, joining the Punch Knuckle Buster Habano and the Maduro releases. Produced at the Hatsa factory in Honduras, the Knuckle Buster shade incorporates a 6-country blend. The blend features Ecuadorian-grown Connecticut shade, Mexican binder, fillers from Colombia, Dominican Republic, Nicaragua, and USA broadleaf. 4 sizes, Robusto, Toro, Gordo, and Stubby. It is priced at 5.39 and 6.09. They are also releasing the Knuckle Buster Maduro Stubby, which, again, it was a separate release, and they didn't have it. So it's a 4.5x60. 20-count boxes at 5.49.
Oh, yeah.
Also, for the trade show, HVCs will introduce the Hot Cake Fresh Out of the Oven Broadleaf. These cigars can be found in the bathroom, and only Jason will smoke them. Fresh out of the oven. This is the third blend to be released under the Hot Cake line. As the name indicates, it'll feature a Connecticut Broadleaf wrapper. I don't think the name indicates that at all. Okay. Produced at Fabrica de Tobacco's HVC SA in Esteli, Nicaragua, the Hot Cake Fresh Out of the Oven also utilizes Nicaraguan tobaccos. Cigars offered in 2 sizes, a Torpedo and a Toro Extra. Fresh Out of the Oven is a limited production release, and they have produced 525 count boxes of each size for the first run.
So, the name indicates, it will feature Connecticut Broadleaf wrapper, and you said you didn't see that, but the name is Fresh Out of the Oven Broadleaf.
Yeah, but like it's only because it says I was thinking of like the fresh out of the oven part or the hot cakes part. Like neither of those is.
No, it's the fresh out of the oven hot cakes. Broadleaf.
I will say no tequila. Corey does read better.
He's more comfortable with the words and whatnot.
It's easy when there's only one set.
Yes, you don't have to unfocus your eyes so that the three of them come together as one.
Hey, Deeds, look at me read these notes.
I can't read them with light.
So yeah, there's that. This is far lighter of a cigar than I was hoping it was.
Yeah, that's...
It's very... There's not a lot of body to it at all.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, it's not intense.
Not what I was expecting, even a little. Yeah.
You pick some, we smoke some, you know?
Yeah, we won't be picking this one's agains.
Well, I mean, we try not to do that anyway. Oh, Jason's coming in. Good.
Although, like, there are two absolutely distinct colors in the wrapper here. If you can see that on mine, like, it looks like there are two different.
That's not necessarily.
See what I'm saying?
Yes, on yours.
Almost like so, that's on purpose.
No, it's not, because it's not on ours.
From where? Although, yeah, yes, is it the band? It's from the band. So the band holds in oils to keep it darker in that strap. Like from here, I can tell it's a dead straight line from the band.
Yeah.
That is two separate pieces of tobacco.
From here, it does not appear that way.
Yeah, it doesn't seem that way from where I'm standing. Did you maybe take too much off when you removed your band?
No.
You go a little too deep?
Oh, Nikes. His really is two separate leaves.
Yeah,
I don't think it is. I think that's the wrap. I think you just have a color difference.
I've never seen that.
Look, band is here.
No. Bear with me when I tell you. What I'm saying is, I think when you wrap your cigar, you have your leaf is stretched out like this. Yes, there are natural color fluctuations in tobacco, and I think what happened is a different coloration just ended up there.
It's a separate leaf.
Yeah.
They were like,
Jason's just got a different blend than we have.
Yeah, I can't wait till I get
Ace
down
to that. Drop the cigar. What are we going to do? Just wrap another leaf on it.
That's exactly what I was thinking. Like, actually, I was thinking more along the lines of he's wrapping it and it tore. And he goes, still grab another one and start putting it on.
Hey, Ryan, how about you don't tell him?
Okay? This band is terrible.
Yeah, this is worse than Romacraft.
Maybe he did peel part of his wrapper.
Really,
off.
Jimmy? Jimmy's down bragging about how it's clear blue skies down there in Kentucky. Oh man.
In
what? I got nothing off.
No.
It's in layers. This is god awful.
Layers like an onion?
Yeah, this is okay. Oh, manufacturers.
Mine's two different Okay, that's a thing. Either? Yeah, it's two separate as well.
Is that just where they end it? Maybe they don't want you putting the...
Maybe that's where all the flavor in this damn cigar is.
Yeah, right here. That last hit.
Yeah, there's a... Mine doesn't have a color distinction, though. So, perhaps... The question is one portion of the wrapper fire-cured and one portion not? And if it is it the portion in your mouth? Somebody needs to smoke one backwards.
It's going to be hot.
All right.
Got to be that guy, huh? You could have at least put the camera. Jack Wagon.
Do it again.
He's like, it's hot now. Uh-uh. Yeah, so apparently that's a construction thing with it. So, yeah, it must be they just... It's like the Hoya Cabinetta does the same thing. What's that?
I need to get some sun.
Some sun?
Yeah, it looks like you're doing the show with Casper, the goateed ghost.
Bro... Last week, I looked completely washed out. It was bad. I'm like,
These lights are...
I think they're excellent.
They're lights.
They're great.
Yeah.
I like it.
That's fair. You're allowed to like it. I'm allowed to not. You
it's
know
fine.
I mean, I'm going to be hitting it. Actually, I might not even need a tanning bed. Just got to do the other side. I'm going to do the show backward next week to even out.
Start getting a tan, man.
Tan man,
the rubber tan.
The snow stopped,
man.
So it's potential.
You know what we
What's
could
that,
do,
Eric? Anybody but you, buddy.
Any way you want it, that's the way you need it. Any way you want it.
You keep your brush to yourself, Eric.
Hey, I mean, if you want, I can go over there and grab you a suction cup hat.
Whole shade.
Put it right there and block some sunlight.
What if they made those poker visors, like the card shuffler visors that just had suction cups on it, so I could just stick it on, like have a visor on the front of my head without having to wear a hat?
This needs to happen.
Right?
Oh,
and then every single one of our shows can be brought to you by Visor.
It's like, it'd be like the Morpheus sunglasses from the Matrix that didn't have any earpieces.
Yep.
Dude, a buddy of mine had a pair of those. And I mean, this is back in like 1999.
Yeah.
So we thought that was the dopest thing ever.
This is what we had, these
Morpheus sunglasses that clipped on his nose right here. And I mean, I could use them, but I've got a ski slope for a nose.
Yeah, yeah. You're building a house on there.
Yeah.
Mine's no better.
It's at a perfect like 40-degree angle.
Yeah, mine's got a bump in the middle though, so I do have that going for me.
Yeah, you got the little bridge bump. Mine's just enormous.
It didn't start that way. I acquired that in a bar in 2006. Mm. So I didn't used to have the bumps, but it's prominent now.
Oh, Sam's a rough and tumble guy.
No, it was a bad night. I think I'm just thinking about it like it's terrible. I got headbutt.
In the nose?
Uh-huh.
That'd be where I'd aim for.
We were talking and dude's like,
you could hit.
Oh yeah? Yeah. Whack. And I'm like, that's what you led with? Like, that's how you started this?
That's such a cheap way to start a fight, dude.
I lost right that fight. Pretty much as soon as his forehead hit my nose.
Yeah.
That was pretty much the end of it.
That's the one place, if you get hit in the beginning of the fight. Yep.
Yeah.
I don't have a lot of experience in this arena, but I would say any person that opens a fight with a headbutt probably gonna win. Like, that's some confidence. Well,
but that's one of those, he won the battle, he lost the war, because I was not alone.
Oh, well, yeah.
Yeah, he did not have clothes when he left there. He did have a lot of bruises.
What kind of friends you hanging out with?
Eric? Very, very angry ones at the time.
Eric's like, I'm here for the fight, baby.
I'll hold the clothes.
Jimmy Green just asked a wonderful question. He said, Corey, how can I get a couple of them shirts?
Well, Sam, since you ask... There is a link available at thecigarjunkies.com under it's weird because you've got it. What is it? Merch or swag?
Swag, I think.
It's under swag. But you click on swag and then there's the shirt and then there's the other shirt, which is in fact the same link, if I'm not mistaken. And although recent promises were made, the construction of our new page at the Galaxy Boutique is still constructing.
Yeah, that's all right. We'll get it all prettied up. But right now,
got one of those.
You've got the option for this one.
This one.
And then there's the one with. Wait, no, this one. Yeah. So there's only two options. Okay. So we do not have a skull one available yet, I don't believe.
They're available if you reach out to Amber, but like if you were just hang tight for another week, Jimmy. I'm thinking by next week. We should be able to get you a good link with any pattern you want. I'm got her putting up the St. Patty's Day logo too, because it's the right time of the year, and it's a popular design anyhow. So you'll have the St. Patrick's Day, the skull logo. You'll have the hand logo. And I don't know if he knows that everyone could see him type it.
No, he can't.
We can't.
Right. Really? You can see it.
What's on there, we see.
You can see it now.
A.com.
I thought it was already visible.
What just happened to your voice, bro?
I don't know.
I thought it was visible. Like, you had a pubescent moment. It was pretty awesome.
Visible. The color options, short sleeve, long sleeve, crew neck, hoodie, they'll all be there.
Yeah, it'll all be showing up soon.
Pretty soon.
I likes it a lot.
Does that look good?
Looks good enough for
everything
what we just
for that we just did.
I think at some point we just need to like put it small across the bottom and leave it there.
I can do that now.
Keith Kilburn.
Let's not do it right now. Let's do it at a time you have time to pick like a font and a text and make it pretty.
See, that's visible. It is dragging it. So they're just seeing it move around.
Now, that they can see.
They can. This is the magic of live theater.
Hey, you need to find out if we can get an animation for it, like the DVD waiting screen, the logo bounces back and forth.
Yes, I can.
And just have it little bouncer.
Yes, I can.
You could drag it now manually if you want. You could just keep like,
follow the hands. That's way too small, but still.
Oh, no, I can do it. Here we go. Put your hands up.
Ooh. What's this way?
Oh, I'll you're holding it.
I'll take it.
I don't.
And then.
We've got the mind of a child.
Yeah. Between the two of us, it actually worked half of a cheese.
Oh, we are so easily amused. It's terrible. It's the little things in life.
Yes, it is.
God, that's what my wife says.
So, Jimmy, hopefully that answered your question a little bit.
Indeed, we do.
Go to.
Hey, diddly dee, are those things for me?
Go to that website right there.
The website.
Ooh. I was thinking we got PCA coming up.
Indeed, we do.
If we appealed to the folks that are listening a little bit, send us questions about PCA and stuff you want to know, and I'll try and answer them since I bins theirs. Yeah, that's pretty much it. You can ask and I'll answer.
I would like to know about mounting. You opened it up.
I don't want to, bud.
Show us on the doll where the prostitute touched you.
Jimmy knows you.
I do know.
He knows where you live.
I do know.
Mm. He's been to your house.
He's one of my in-laws' cousins.
He's like, I've been inside your house.
I don't think he's been inside of our house. Maybe he did. But
he's not been inside your house?
We've been inside a Chinese restaurant.
Okay. So.
So much MSG. Kill everything.
Oh, MSG has a flavor.
A flavor.
That dude. Uncle Roger.
I love him so much.
One of my favorite YouTubers.
Emotional.
No, that's not that guy. That's the dude with the son. They call it Steven. Uncle Roger's, he's got an orange polo.
Yeah. It's the same dude.
That's not the emotional damage guy. Somebody completely different.
I thought it was.
It's snowing again.
It hasn't stopped,
it
bro.
It did stop. The last time I looked out the window, I was like, it stopped snowing.
You can't look at your truck and expect to see the snow. Betty White hides it quite efficiently.
But she has tires. It's very obvious if it's snowing or if it's not snowing. Last time I looked,
it's not obvious because you obviously missed it. How obvious it was.
It stopped momentarily.
All right, fair
obviously,
enough.
It's not obvious enough.
Obliviously.
Meanwhile, there's cops pounding on the door over here, and there's some guy just shaking his bag out over the window.
What that's a bad joke.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I told you that's the only kind I have.
Okay, that one, you really, I think, reached out for it.
Appreciate it.
I am happy to not have the massive hand on this episode. That was, dude, he was so amused with the perspective.
We should have made that the thumbnail. Just dude, because he's like smoking a cigar with his hand out here.
Mm-hmm.
Like and this. It's just like, yes.
Yeah, like that. It was
like this the whole episode. He's like holding his cigar. Because
the camera
out
was like
here.
Right here. He so like I'm like talking. It's like.
Well, I'll tell you what. So we had our meeting on Friday or Thursday or whenever the heck
it was.
I'm
surprised you remember.
And Corey paid me a very good compliment. He was like, you know what? Since we brought you on, he goes, I didn't realize how crappy it was on the other side of that.
I don't even think that's the way I worded it.
You were like, I appreciate what you do.
I was reluctant to give over control because, first of all, I took pride in doing both things at the same time and doing the technical stuff. And I did have just learned all this crap from nothing, sure. Right? Like, we had to figure it all out as we went. And more often than not, that created problems. But I didn't want to hand over control of it to somebody else just because I'm a little OCD. And as much as it pains me sometimes to watch you do things in a way that I wouldn't, just because it's like making my skin crawl, it's nice to have you here. And when you're not here, you're missed.
You look over and it's like a cat covered in yarn, like Jason's producing the podcast.
Oh, that one was so close.
I'll pay for it anyway.
I watched you look down at the quarters like, what's up, bro?
Maybe that's how you pay for one that was close, but no cigar. You close just to hit the rim.
I'll pay for it anyway.
Yeah, he just gave us a rim job.
I do appreciate you.
Is that
producing.
What you appreciate about him?
I'd appreciate it more if he would show up and help carry in gear all the time.
Well, I mean, you could wait till I get here.
There is that.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the problem is we don't know when you're going to get here.
We also are
so like we might need that lead in.
I've been pretty good.
You have. But we don't know, Jason. We don't know if you remembered that it was daylight savings time or not.
We're just.
I didn't. I found out when I got into the car this morning.
Oh, and you're like, why am I so?
Man, I don't feel like I slept very long. I get in the car. I start the car up. I start backing up my driveway, and I look at the clock, and I'm like, 7:28. What? There's no way it's 7:28. Looked out on my phone. It's at 8:28. I was like, oh, no.
I don't know what masochist decided that it was a good idea to, like, have to switch the clocks a couple of times a year. Stupid farmers.
I think we should get rid of daylight savings time.
For sure.
Period.
Just leave it alone. Let it be.
Is the altered time the one that gives us the sun until 9 o'clock in the summertime?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So this is where it needs to be. Yeah.
I don't care where it is in the winter. Because it's cold out and it sucks outside anyway. Who cares if it's light or dark?
Although in the fall.
There's so many dumb reasons that people come up with for it.
In the fall, that was my favorite day to go out and drink at the bar.
Extra hour.
Because you got that extra hour. It was like 1:59, and then all of a sudden it's 1 o'clock in the morning again, and you're like, pff, pff, pff,
hey, can we take a note of what day that is? We'll do our next our podcast meeting for the week. We'll have to be on that day. So we're like, man, it feels like we've been doing this meeting a lot longer than 3 hours.
We'd have to start the meeting at like 11 o'clock at night.
Yeah, I won't be here.
Sam's like,
you guys enjoy that their daylight savings nights.
No thanks.
No, thank you very much. I will be enjoying my extra sleep that day, not my removed sleep. That's Britt and I were talking yesterday, and I'm like, sweetie, you got to go to bed. She's like, why? I'm like, it's 1 o'clock in the morning. She's like, no, it's midnight. I'm like, I know, but in 2 hours, is going to have been 1 o'clock. And she goes, well, oh, I'm like, yeah, it clicked. Yeah. Like, yeah, hey, you're on the wrong schedule right now.
Well, so I got home a little bit late again yesterday. We took a quick nap, and so Shannon's still having her nap. I didn't wake her up because I'm like, well, I got to get all my notes and crap out of the way for today. So it's like, I'm going to go do all the things so she doesn't have to sit around and wait on me. And then I woke her up. We get down. So we didn't hang out for a long time in the garage. But I'm like, I just need you to understand that this is daylight savings. And I have to get up for the podcast in the morning. So, like, even though it's 11, it's midnight. And even though it's midnight, it's 1. So, like... Yeah, I was hyper aware of the fact that it was daylight savings time. Yeah. I still got too little sleep, and I still feel like crap.
Hey, guess what?
Chicken?
Guess what all the flavor in that cigar is? As soon as I hit that wrapper. Wow.
Good flavor, bad flavor?
A lot of flavor, it looks like. It just... No?
Uh-uh. It was... an abrupt change because my cigar was burning very, very evenly down. So the construction of the cigar is great.
That's a great example, though, how much of a difference just the wrapper makes.
Oh, yeah.
Like the lowest proportional item on the thing.
That's not the binder?
Wow.
Because it's not.
Because I can see it.
But it's not binded. Oh. Yeah, that's a good 100%. Example of like exactly what how much of a role it really plays. It is getting pungent. I'm not going to lie.
Dude, wait till you hit that. If you even make it that far.
It's starting to become a lot.
My limited experiences with this cigar that I've had before, I'm like, it's a good name. I feel like I'm smoking a chicken bone.
Chicken bone.
There's actually it's a Seinfeld scene too. It's like they're sitting there trying to, Elaine and Jerry are trying to smoke the cigars. But they have them in their teeth, and they won't take them out of their mouth. So, like, they're trying to talk through the cigar. And she's like, I taste like a chicken bone. He's like, what do you say? A chicken bone.
There is a special talent. There is a special talent to being able to talk with a cigar.
How about the lost talent of, like, the little old ladies in the 90s that would just have a 100...
Oh yeah,
cigar,
and it wasn't even when they talked.
It wasn't even in their mouth. Like I knew a lady named Joan.
It was glued to your lip.
Yeah,
they used to do it all the time.
I would work with her at Kogo's, and it would be like defying physics,
mm-hmm.
just glued there.
Yeah,
and it just.
And she just talked, and it
reminds me of what I was thinking of before. We're talking about, oh, we'll just wait for Jason to get here to unload the equipment, and he strolls in at like, you know, 9:45. We're all catching flies on the couch. He walks to tap you on the shoulder like you're burning a hole in the freaking arm.
Yeah. Hey, buddy.
But that was my mom. My mom, like, have you ever seen the like the YouTube shorts or the YouTube videos where it's like Pittsburgh cigarette mom? Mm-mm. And it's just some woman on the couch talking on the phone, smoking a 100, and she's just sitting there cussing, and she's like, "Ins guys need to go down here, get Jimmy out of the neighbor's house, and bring him back up here."
The important question I have is, was it a corded phone, and was the cord stretched all the way straight?
Yeah.
You know, it's like
340 feet around the house.
She's just waiting for, like, you know, a kid to say something bad. She lets go of that phone. It goes through three different rooms and whack.
So my dad's been in telecommunications. So we had this, the long cord, but ours was no BS, like 75 feet long, the coil cord. So you could take it from the kitchen, go through the living room, around the corner, up the stairs to the second floor, so mom could do laundry while she was on the phone. Because she'd end up talking to my aunts and be like, "Well, I was stuck on the phone." And he's like, "All right, fix that."
Somebody suggested.
And then she'd be like, "Sam!" Sam would come up. She's like, "Go hang this back on the receiver."
Never called me Sam. Boy!
Yeah. Oh, boy. Yeah.
That was it. I was boy. My brother was junior.
Why'd they even name you guys?
You know what? For the first 6 years of my life, I thought my name was God Damn It.
Yeah. No, Damn It's okay.
No, not with the God.
Oh, yeah. When you add God to it, it's blasphemy.
Yeah, well, I'll pay for that one.
It's the sand.
Somebody wanted to try a segment on this show where live audience members would ask a question.
Yeah.
I'm not suggesting we do that now because we asked them earlier and they gave us nothing.
Yeah.
But what I would like to see if we could do. Can we get two old school phones with the cord on it and hang one right here? And just go, okay, it's time. And then, like, whoever's got their question can walk up to the wall on the other side of the room and we can pick it up. And
oh, so you want a Femco here?
That'd be great.
You know what? I'm thinking two cups with a string would work and be way more on brand for us.
Yeah. But Eric would probably fill the cup.
But we can have like a mic stand with a cup on it. Two bottoms, one cup. Anyways. I hear peace. I'm out.
Just imagine him going, "Hey, save the smallest Funyun for me."
Yeah. Just distracted by the Funyun. Would you like some Funyuns?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, there's, and we don't need to go
Funyuns, man.
Yeah. Some Funyuns, bro.
If I'm not back in 5 minutes, call the police. If he ain't back in 5 minutes, we're calling Domino's.
Oh, so
how far they've fallen, Domino's.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the guys in that movie.
No, I mean, some of them probably.
Sure, Dave Chappelle's still doing really well.
He's doing pretty good now that he's doing that whole Netflix
who's
thing.
Jim Brewer, have you seen like any of Jim Brewer's stuff recently?
No.
Like that guy,
okay,
he's out there, man.
I'm gonna say this because it's like painted in the right light. Jim Brewer and fucking Dave Chappelle.
Gotcha.
Dave Chappelle.
Hey, you know what, dude?
Are a perfect illustration of why black folks just age so much better.
Oh,
Black folks hit 40 and just stay the same. They never get older than that. Whereas Jim Brewer looks like a Kleenex under a teenage kid's bed.
You almost made him spit that out.
Not almost.
That's a good girl.
Ow. Oh, that's...
Yeah, yeah.
Man, and I liked that whiskey before that, too, and I don't anymore. That's
is that why you don't drink Ardbeg anymore?
Oh.
The retro hails.
That was a lot. That was, Yeah, that was a decent amount there.
Oh, that'll clean your sinuses up.
See,
I can breathe clearly now.
Drinking on the show's for professionals. Gone.
I used to be pro, but I done dropped back down to the amateurs. I'm no longer theirs.
Skip that one for now. He's pulling it up.
All righty. He's pulling
it out. It's time for the events.
It is. We have no bumpers no more.
No.
You are the bumper, so go ahead and bump the show up.
Bump,
bump, bump,
bump, bump it up.
Bump, 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 bump. That would actually be... That dude, Jason,
bump, bump,
I've
bump
got the vocal
up.
Harmonizer pedal. We should make one for the call to action that's just all of us doing like a little barbershop quartet of bump, 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 bump.
Bum,
bum, bum, he likes bum, it. Bum, 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 guys, if you were listening, if you're watching, only you can prevent us from falling into being, what's the opposite of notoriety?
Obscurity.
Obscurity. Help us not fall, well, not fall deeper into obscurity by liking, subscribing, and sharing on every platform. What platform, you ask? I'm glad you asked. Is Spotify. Podbean. Well, no, Podbean is like 70 episodes behind.
Just pick a platform.
Pick
we're probably
an audio
there.
Platform, and we're there. Video, YouTube, we're there for you. Facebook, Facebook group, or you can find all the goodness at one location. What location, you ask? I'm glad you asked. It's CigarJunkies.com.
I wish I could make it like Flash.
Is it even on the screen? Because you're hiding it with the other window.
I'm having a... Yeah, it's right there.
Okay. We thought you were pulling it. Okay.
I'm having a hard time scrolling down through the website on the browser.
Hit the hamburger menu top left corner.
Oh, yes.
Hamburger menu?
Yeah, right there.
I'll have a double, please.
So
go even to if the actual window. Screen.
You keep reading. I'm going to help him real quick.
He's going to help him out. I wasn't even reading anything. Yes, only you can help us. Not only that, but did you guys know we have a Patreon? We do. You go to patreon.com/thecigarjunkies, and you can give us some of your sweet, sweet money. That's what we want. We want your money. Don't give us stars. We don't know what they're for. We don't know how to get them. But money, currency is great. Digital, physical. You can leave a tip on the table before you leave if you want to. We'll take your money in anything. Pesos.
I'll find it.
Francs. Doubloons.
Francs.
Doubloons.
Doubloons.
Yeah. All of those money. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I improv better with the
improvisation. Mm-hmm. Sorry. Okay. Did you read the events? Sorry.
No, because y'all started stretching out about the bumps and all that stuff. Let's talk about the events. Tuesday, March 12th at Dirty Dog. Give me all that green bleep. AB Zone. I can't wait until this month is over, so I don't have to keep saying this name. Ryan Ponist is back with the best of the green labels, Filthy Hooligan, Shamrocks, and Tullamore Dew. Now, it doesn't have to be green and get great deals on it. Just has to be from the shop's top brand, Alec Bradley. Don't know about you, but that's got me feeling lucky.
You feeling lucky?
Not particularly, no. I got to work today. Saturday, March 16th at Main Street Tavern in Munn Hall. You can come see the monthly acoustic show. Corey and Nick will be playing a diverse lineup of all your favorites and maybe something special for St. Paddy's Day. Come wear your green and hang out with Pittsburgh's junkiest acoustic duo of all of the acoustic acts in the area. We're one of them. Sunday, March 17th at Smokestack, Everything Tobacco. It's back! One of the largest and most anticipated events of the year. Ryan Ponist of Forged Cigar will be there with plenty. I thought he was with Alec Bradley. I know. It's owned by Forged. It's just a joke I make every week until I don't have to read it anymore.
Yeah, almost there.
Plenty of limited and sought-after Filthy Hooligans and Shamrocks to go around. Deals on Alec Bradley products, including the new post-embargo blend B15, will help you earn tickets to win amazing prizes. What kind of prizes, you ask? How about a custom Alec Bradley custom DuPont lighter cutter set?
That's a lot of custom.
How about special rare bottom bottle of Alec Bradley X Starlight barrel pick and more? Food, fun, festivities to go around. And they'll also have Penn Brewery Slingin' Brews
Slingin'
to keep
brews.
The merriment going. Not going to want to miss this. Don't get left out. Only at the Stack. We likes the green in the Pittsburgh.
Is that what we digs?
Yeah, dude, that delay was bad. You weren't even back in your seat yet.
Oh, you're way behind then.
Indeedly. No, it was on the computer screen.
Oh,
Yeah.
That's not
It doesn't matter.
It's okay.
Yeah, as long as it's right on here, yep. Right? You know what I'm saying?
We just had a delay, that's all.
But yeah. So you want to cover that there top thing now? The mains parts?
Sounds like you kind of
I'm just going to go to the GoFundMe page.
Well, no, I wanted to navigate there. That was the whole point.
Yeah,
so,
cool. We can do that.
So yeah. So for anybody who doesn't know, Dave and Patty, Chichingo, sorry.
Chichingo, Ringo, Dave.
Dave and Patty.
Wicks. I don't know how to say that last name.
What is it? Oh, yes. It's Mass something Polishes.
Yeah, there's things. There's
so they've fallen on some medical issues, and you know, they support our community so much, you know, just and statewide. I can't even say, you know, I can't even say that it's just like they support like Pittsburgh area. Like they statewide, they support cigars nationally if they can. They you know, they're at it and they do
it. Imagine the sweetest people you can possibly think of, and then roll them in sugar, and Patty maybe a little salt.
Yeah, some white pepper in there too.
So maybe just a little dirt. She got her thoughts go a little dirty.
Oh yeah,
but just
that's
the
a good
nicest, most generous people you've ever met.
Yeah,
100%.
So because of what they're going through, we wanted to try and help them out, just alleviate things as much as we can, just because they've done so much for everybody. So on our website, if you guys go there, thecigarjunkies.com, you will see a tab for Help Dave and Patty. Slide down that. You can kind of check out a brief little excerpt about them. And then down towards the bottom, you'll see a magical blue button. And I think I've made it pretty on the nose there where it says donate. So, you know, click on that. That's going to take you to the GoFundMe and give. That's
please,
it. That's,
if you
I'm
can.
Done. That's what I'm going to say.
They're at $50 right now. And that is, I'm not paying for this one. That's bullshit. If you're out there and you
that started last night,
yeah,
at
nobody
midnight.
Knows about
no,
it.
This
right
is the
now.
First.
It has
this
been
literally just dropped.
Yet.
All right.
So I'm going to make it fair.
Settle down there. I think you do have to pay. I think instead of putting a quarter in the jar, you should put some money where your mouth
ooh,
is.
Ooh, there's it is.
Hey. Me, I'm going to do that.
There it is. Dude, well played. Right. Well played.
So if you are in the Pittsburgh area, we will update the website, our website, which website? TheCigarJunkiesPodcast.com
or
TheCigarJunkies.com.
There it is.
And you'll be able to go on there and see what local shops have events going on to benefit Dave. There will be a couple of different options, some stuff over at Leaning House, Superior. I know the St. Patty's events are going to have different things set up. As we have those details together, we will update the tab on our website so you guys know where you can go out in person, support Chichingo and Patty, and help them out. Because, I mean, anytime you got medical issues going on, there's a lot of factors there. Your ability to work, income lost, medical bills generated. It's just a bad time, and you have to deal with the ailments as well.
All the so not fun.
It's also not fun.
It's terrible. Just terrible, terrible, terrible.
Yeah. Give what you can. Tell your friends. All that jazz. We'll start sharing it to the Junkies Facebook group. We'll start, you know, just really trying to push it out there and get it through the works as best as we can. I don't push know. It. Push it good. All right, well played.
Real good.
I was like, where is he going? I missed a reference.
Now I see how you guys feel every Sunday.
Yeah. You're like, oh, this is not as much fun. No, it is
that's
fun.
Fine.
It
that's
is fine. It's great. All right.
Look at
I'm trying to make
monkey.
It to the line of doom here.
It is the line of doom. I promise.
Look, see, you're not there. I told you.
What the heck?
Every time you tab lagged. Out and come back in,
it goes back
it does
to that
again.
Spot.
All right, watch this.
Oh, hey, yo, watch it.
That was where we're broadcasting from, wasn't it?
Yeah, I can hit the refresh button. It's
okay.
Yeah.
Hoping it stays up.
But I'm like, trust me, I've hit the refresh button.
Do you often have problems keeping it up?
More often than not. Yeah, for sure.
He's like, yeah.
Every 37 seconds or so. Yeah, I'd like to take an excerpt from Futurama and just have it be like a little video that pops up. You got it, Ben, the episode where Bender is like against technology until he like remakes his body out of wood. He's like stuck on the island with the outdated technology. You didn't see this episode? No. It's one of the best ones, dude. And there's like all these outdated things, and one of them's a cymbal banging monkey. And he just sits there and bangs his cymbals. And Bender's like, "You really got this life thing figured out, cymbal banging monkey."
And that's it.
That's it.
Oh, that's.
That's all I needed.
That's for all that. You yeah. were throwing in there.
It would be better just if the little video clip came up of just that little 5-second excerpt.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Don't worry, I'll cut this segment out in post.
He's like, "Yeah, we're getting rid of that stupid monkey." Did you have something from your question you asked the audience earlier, or I have one I can bring up if you would like?
Get at it, pitter patter.
So we talk about, you know, like we were talking about Retro Hill. We've talked about a couple different things over the last couple of weeks, and
some of them made it onto the show.
Yeah, some of them, even the whole thing, made it on too. So that's crazy.
Damn it!
But it worked out well, though. At least we had like that one like chunk of it before it went bad, and it was a nice transition. But no, so filtration, like air filtration, something that
I know nothing about.
Yeah, that's what I figured, you know, ask questions about it because I've done way more research than I ever would have liked to. Like, can you?
Yeah.
I mean, do you have any like specific questions? Would be kind of my lead in on that.
I would say let's go with the easiest one, right? So, say you're just a consumer, say you got a spot in your house you'd like to be able to smoke, but you don't want your wife chasing you around with a rolling pin for stinking up her house.
Yeah.
What is the most budget friendly option to eliminate cigar smoking for one or two individuals in an otherwise non-smoking home?
So, not being funny, duct tape and a box fan.
Okay, let's
cover up. No.
Let's
like,
say
cover up your vents. That's the most important part. So, like, if you have forced air in your house and you have a return air vent, don't forget to cover that when you're going to smoke, because that fan's going to pull more than any filtration unit on the market.
Let's assume you don't have the benefits of a window.
No, I'm saying, like, even without the window, if you have forced air in your house, you have to cover up that return air duct, and preferably the inlet air duct.
Okay.
Because if your furnace kicks on while you're smoking a cigar, even if you have one of these nice charcoal units there, it's going to go to the furnace, sure, and then it's going to go to the rest of your house.
Right.
And that's very upsetting. And
that's
then
weird. I smoke right next to my return vent in my house.
Really?
Yeah, right next to it. And I blow the smoke right into it.
Yeah, and then you just have like one outlet right over Jen's face in bed and just like,
oh yeah,
keep your nicotine. No.
Just imagine Jen coming down in the morning and looking over and Jason's just squatting over the return vent.
And we went there.
Eating refried beans
so much
out of
for
a can.
That note. But no, so beyond that, like if you're just looking for something for in the house, Coway is what I went with here in the shop, and they are price approachable, like very approachable compared to
Callaway.
Coway, Coway.
Oh, that is all right.
But they are extremely efficient. They work really, really well. They do not clean the air as efficiently.
I thought he was going to type cow.
They don't clean the air nearly as efficiently as like a Rabbit Air does, but they move more air. So when I did the maths, you know, yeah, a single pass of a Rabbit Air is cleaner, but it's going to go through the Coway unit like 3 to 4 times.
I got an idea.
You know, compared to the good.
Okay. So you know a lot about this subject matter, and we've got a friend that knows a lot about filtration too from True Rest.
Yeah.
Yes. We team up. We start our own brand of air filters, the Redneck brand, and we call them, instead of Coway, we call them Cattle Guards.
Nope. You missed that one.
Yeah, you fell through on there, bud. I mean, good, but not great.
It's not any worse than Coway.
It's literally the name of the company.
But it shouldn't be, is what I'm getting at.
Yeah, no, I didn't create it. I was just saying that, like, you asked what the best budget-friendly option is. That's usually it.
Yeah.
You know, but I mean, the biggest thing is if you can get the smoke out, that's the preference. But remember, any air you take out of the room, you have to replace with tempered air for that. Patty! Sorry.
Patty.
We're getting distracted. Patty Dunn showed up in the chats.
Is she St. Patty?
Of course she's St. Patty. She's basically the Saints. Patty, do me a favor. Go to thecigarjunkies.com and comment back on your thoughts. But yeah, so if you can, you know, like keep the room under negative pressure. So try and have a fan that's pulling out of the room to somewhere else. That's going to help keep it. Dunky Doug said it's co-way, not cow-way. It's cow-way. Cow-way? Kawai? Kawai? I don't know.
You're putting the emphasis.
I put the emphasis on the cow instead of the co. Cow.
On the plus side, with Cattle Brand air filters, we could corner the entire market of anybody that has in-home pet cows.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like if we're gonna do Cattle Brand filters, that has to be a methane collection system to go along with every one.
That would benefit Jenna as well.
Yeah. All them cows farting is ruining the atmosphere.
Read the sign.
That wasn't a that was. You know what? I'm gonna mute your microphone. Go away.
Wow. That's how I felt for the first like year. No,
I stretched my legs.
But yeah, so you know that's an option. Pulling the air out of the room. But if you pull air out of the room, you have to either heat or cool that air if you want it to be fresh and so clean. And then as you kind of move up through it, you know, then you get into a co-op system where you have air coming out like a removal system as well as a filtration system. And then from there, you've got the big dog, which is get a shed.
Problem with an exterior building is I'm not doing it without HVAC. So you get yourself one of them
Mr.
Cool heat pumps or whatever. That'd be the way to go. And I wouldn't want a shed. I'd want a barn, full barn.
Yeah, see, that's the part. I need
10 of those.
But like, okay, I was actually talking to somebody about this the other day. He wants to do like a smoking shed for him and like 10 of his buddies. I'm like, wow, dude, like that's aggressive. I said, but before you do that, like, how often are your friends gonna be there? And he's like, well, what do you mean? I'm like, well, like, how often do you plan on sitting down smoking cigars with 10 people? He's like, and I was like, once a year?
I only have 3 friends. I was twice just a year? The shed would like, how, like more.
How many times do you really expect to get 10 people together for it?
I mean, if he has a weekly poker game or something right. like that,
and that's why I was
that's
asking.
A different story. Yeah,
for me, it's once a year.
Yeah. So, like, okay, at that point, do you wanna completely modify your living situation so you can have the shed, or maybe get a small building where you and 2 friends can sit, have a cigar, comfortable, and make it way nicer inside. Like, you know, that there's that scalability to it too.
Also, because you got like 6 months a year where you could theoretically just do it outside.
Sure.
Oh yeah.
But speaking of a smoking barn, I would really like an underground bunker.
Right,
like a shipping container, like get 2 shipping containers and bury them out in your yard.
What do you do if you have an underground bunker and you want to not smoke it up?
So you have a.
You love how quick he's just like, let's go.
So,
I mean, theoretically, it should already have a pretty good air scrubbing system.
You're gonna have to,
yeah. Or else it's not a very good underground bunker.
So you bring your fresh air in down to the bottom,
filter out the radiation.
And then you have your exhaust pipe going out and natural flow of things. It will move air. It'll actually create its own air current. I don't know why I know that.
I
remember
want that. To set the world on fire.
God, that was a great, great game.
You know they're coming out with a show, right?
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Fallout, yeah.
They are coming out with a show and I cannot wait.
For some reason, when you sang that, I wasn't thinking of Fallout. I was thinking of Bioshock.
Oh, that's definitely not Bioshock.
No.
That's
Fallout.
But once although, you another clarify. Very, very great game.
Yeah.
But, I feel such like a fun that guy's my ghost of future, Christmas future.
Really?
Striking similarities.
You buying stilts?
I haven't stood next to him. I don't know how.
Nah, he's only got you by like 4 inches, so you're good. So standard. You know,
the April 12th. April 12th, the Fallout show premieres on Amazon Prime Video.
Hey, I have that one. I hate when something comes out and it's like, it looks cool. I ain't buying it.
Nah, I'm good.
You know what?
Actually, you know what? Yeah.
You know what's probably going to be awful, but I still kind of want to watch it anyway, is the Anthony Mackie Twisted Metal show.
Oh, I actually heard that was okay.
I would like to see it, but it's on like, what is it on?
Like Peacock or something.
Which is such a strange brand.
It's NBC.
Yeah. Because it's a show about post-apocalyptic people killing each other in cars.
Yeah, okay.
It just doesn't seem like their branding. That seems more Hulu or HBO or Prime or literally anybody but Peacock. Is it just because Anthony Mackie's so stylish? I don't know.
I have no idea. But go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Bad words.
Embrace the darkness.
I lean like this.
It was the
put my hand on the chair.
That got me. Like, hold on,
let me slide over here. That's gonna bruise. Bad words.
Eric, don't look. Yeah. Took you long enough. Why do you think I slid my chair over?
Ow. Owie.
Much lower and close your fist.
Fart, that hurt. Haha.
Hey, he said no fart jokes.
That wasn't a joke.
I didn't say no fart jokes. That's true, he didn't. No poop jokes.
Which is funny because you said that, but I didn't make any poop jokes. I made a fart joke. And okay, then you put up no poop jokes.
No toilet humor.
Well, then just end the show now, bro.
Yeah. Look at you. I mean, you've taken everything out of our quiver. What are our final thoughts on the Kentucky Fire Curid? I think probably the same as most of the thoughts we've had already.
Have you made it to the Band of Doom?
I'm really close. I will say, the thing burns for a while. It has not gone out on me a single time.
When I hit the Band of Doom, there was some weird... It went out. And then I lit it again. It went out again. And I lit it a third time. And when I lit it the third time, it smoked into that and...
Oh,
buddy.
Am I the only one that hearing Band of Doom generates like a Timu version of Gwar in my mind?
It did not.
It's there now.
It didn't do a Timu version of Gwar, but it definitely put Death Clock up there.
That was so much fun. That cartoon was awesome.
Metalocalypse was
great. That was so good.
My name is Murderface. Murderface.
I bet you we could get a lot of views if we all just came in to film some videos dressed as like notable appearance bands. Like
we dress up as Kiss.
No, I was thinking
I'd do that.
I was thinking one of us dresses up like someone from Kiss, one of us from Insane Clown Posse, one person from like Gwar. So it's just like this weird mashup, like we all got the wrong memo. And then we just sing Public Domain songs like Marianna Little Lamb.
Marianna. Got Steamboat Willie dancing across the screen.
Just like the weirdest mashup of none of this works together.
So I think we do that, but we also incorporate your idea of the beatboxing thing at the same time.
Yeah.
So like
I had a beatboxing idea.
What was it? It was, I don't know.
Acapella.
Yeah, but you know, there was a thing about, you know, whatever. And then we started doing it. And it's in the show. We'll watch it later. But there was a thing that you mentioned us doing something. I forget the deets now. Because okay. I moved on.
That's cool.
I restructured. Corey should dress up like...
I don't know who that is.
Caillou?
Yeah. I'm guessing that's something to do with anime.
Yeah.
Mm. Hold it in.
Oh man,
he's Krillin.
Or the
look
last,
at him. Look at him.
Last
look at him. He's Krillin.
So I had drawn up a little like anime version of the logo, right?
Did you put a arrow on my head?
I used Krillin as the basis for Corey because I was like, man, I need a bald headed guy, and I was like. Krillin's bald headed. Oh, rip
is.
Akira Toriyama, dude.
What?
Akira Toriyama?
Yeah.
The creator of Dragon Ball? Oh. He died like 2 days ago.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
He wasn't that old, was he?
65 or something like that.
Really? I thought he'd be like 120.
No, dude, they haven't been doing that.
Dragon Balls are always drawn out. It's like, find out the exciting conclusion next week. And it's literally just the same two clips back and forth
well,
of
that's
guys
why,
powering up, but nobody's shooting anything.
That's why they remade Dragon Ball Z, and they called it Dragon Ball Kai.
Kai. So
and
much better.
It was an abridged version of Dragon Ball
all
Z.
All the random dialogue and crap that just was there as
so
filler
it's like
is
if
gone.
You took out the educational content of this show for cigar smokers... I just made a clip of that versus our whole episode.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah. It would be a 25 minute episode.
Yeah.
I was thinking
lucky.
5 minutes for us.
If I ever made it 5 minutes, she'd be a lot happier. So, yeah, I'll take five.
Hey, why do you think I'm so tired?
You got three kids and one shot, so.
Just remember, the smaller the orifice, the higher the pressure.
Oh, indeed, yeah.
I just think, so you said the thing about the kids and the shots, and I was just thinking back to Homer Simpson again, who I am very much the, like, real-life version of. It's like, I got three kids and no money. Why can't I have no kids and three money?
All right, I'm approaching the Band of Doom.
Band of Doom. Can we get transparent background animation, just like a blue screened animation that you would have come up like at the bottom of a Fox TV show during primetime, right? Mm-hmm. Doing the advertisements for those, like the Sunday football robot doing a touchdown dance.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
But it's just Beavis and Butthead like rocking out.
So yes, time, I can do that.
Every time we start singing something goofy, you just push the button and Beavis and Butthead come up.
That's actually really good.
I wonder if we get spanked for that.
Probably.
If they DRM us.
They got to be close to public domain.
Oh, we have
now.
To do.
Who, Beavis and Butthead?
Yeah,
it's 100 years.
It's 100 years of 100
years. What about
Mickey Mouse? It's Mike Judge. He doesn't do things normal. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. It might. It's something worth looking up.
What if we just did a anime version of Eric and Ryan Seneca on their, like, superimpose their faces on Beavis
might
and Butthead?
Listen. So I'm getting into the animation software and. I could probably draw up a Beavis and Butthead version of you and Corey and, doing some dumb stuff like that.
Beaver and Groundhog.
He has to be Cornholio, though.
Oh, yeah.
T-shirt has to be up.
Yeah, of course. But you said Beaver and Groundhog. You guys are like, you remember the show The Angry Beavers?
You do understand, yes. I was born on Groundhog's Day, right?
You were?
Yeah. He's the Groundhog.
I am the Groundhog.
Oh, man, I'm going to start calling you Groundhog. That's it. Your nickname's Groundhog.
It's like, it just made me think of what cartoon is that? I just realized that's Homer smoking pot. He got pot. He's like, I just realized I am the walrus.
Cuckoo-ca-choo.
Cuckoo-ca-choo. It's like, I realize I am the groundhog.
That's it, dude. You're groundhog.
Yeah, groundhog and beaver. And then we can get old honey badger in.
Yeah.
And the skunk.
I'm the skunk.
Yeah, 100%.
100%. Yeah,
but not like the cute stinky skunk. You're like the rapey Pepe Le Pew skunk.
Yes.
Yes. Dude, you looked at me with such concern. Like, where are you going with? Yeah.
So Amber, that makes the lady that makes our t-shirts, she makes a lot of like Disney property shirts and stuff with licensed properties on it.
Yeah.
I'm going to definitely reach out to her and say, can you put Pepe Le Pew on a t-shirt and just have rapey above it?
Oh my God.
the eighth dwarf. And it's just Pepe Le Pew.
that would sell it Hot Topic in like 2003.
Oh yeah.
Like,
but then just get a video of like, you could like promote it. It's just a video of you going through the seven dwarves and just like point. And Jason pops the dwarves
sleepy,
up.
Sleepy, happy, grumpy, sleepy, dopey, happy, sneezy, grumpy, bashful, dog, rapey.
And just like roll through it like it's no big deal. And then, but then immediately shows Snow, what's her name, laying there sleeping. And Pepe Le Pew going, oh, yes.
Just a little white drip
we'll on
Sleeping Beauty's face.
Oh, God.
Or you could have one of the dwarfs like wiping her face off with a paper towel.
Oh, jeez.
The hardest part about that is that you would have two licenses. You'd have to worry about Disney and Warner Brothers.
Yeah, but they're both going to be like, you know what? We don't need to touch that one. We're
going to
let
them. They don't need to know what's going on that shirt.
It's time to end the show.
It's time to win the show.
It's time to end the show.
Time to end the show.
So you like popped up and you're like, oh, an Amber. And all I could think was, oh. When Corey randomly thinks of Amber, he has an Amber Alert.
I do. Amber Alert.
Yeah.
That's that. Oh.
No?
That's not okay? The association we're looking
What's
for.
What's going on really. There?
Just.
What's the matter, Jay?
Nothing.
You okay?
Yeah.
You all right, buddy?
Make sure you guys check us out at thecigarjunkies.com, Gmail, and Just the Tip website as well. What's that website, you ask?
Just the Tip Cigars.
You couldn't get justatip.com, huh?
No. Nah.
That one was a lot more expensive.
I looked it up, and you know, like sometimes it says, oops, something went wrong. It just said seats taken. So I don't know what that meant.
Hey, that's Eric. What she said. How much to sell justatip.com URL to Sam?
Never mind. It's okay. So anyways.
Go to meatspin.com.
Okay. I initially in my head, it was spelled M-E-E-T. But so I'm like, or is it?
M-E-A-T.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's the second place my mind went. Yeah. It's like spin the bottle, but with a Polish sausage in there or something like that, you know? Please support Cigars for Warriors, Cigar Rights of America, and Mission 22. And more importantly, support Dave and Patty.
Cha-chingo.
Cha-chingo. Ringo. You can find that on one of the tabs on our website. Next week's cigar is going to be The Judge by My Father. Ooh. Hang out with us every Sunday at 9:30 live on Facebook, where you can join the conversation. Say the words.
Salud.